Yo era el más alto en casa. A menos que mi papá llegaría, ¿verdad? Pero yo era el más alto en casa. Ella era chiquita, ¿verdad que sí? Ella era chiquitita. Si ella conoce a mi hermana. Praise God, hallelujah. Rest. This is just way God makes us. Praise God. But still with all those deficiencies, praise God, con toda esa dificultad y todas esas cosas que no hace falta, podemos ver la imagen y semejanza de Dios. We can still see the image and the likeness of who? Of God. Praise God, hallelujah. Pero las aflicciones han venido por deseos del pecado del hombre. Hallelujah. The affliction has come, praise God, for the desire of man to do sin. As soon as Adam ate of the fruit, now don't blame the women. Because a lot of people say, oh, esa mujer. Even Adam said it in the scriptures. Esa mujer que me diste, that woman that you gave me. That woman you gave me of the fruit. Am I right? That's what the scripture said. Yeah. Praise God. But the pact wasn't with the woman. It was with who? With the man. He made man first. And the Bible says, praise God, out of the what? Out of the side of the man, he took what? Wool, man. So from the beginning, it was going to be a wool. Am I right? Wool, man. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Pero desde el principio Dios planeó, hallelujah, para que el hombre fuera perfecto. From the beginning, God has made man to be man being perfect. But he went ahead and messed it up. Messed it up. Praise God. Hallelujah. When all these situations of sin, y toda la situación de pecado, hoy en día tenemos las enfermedades que están en este mundo. Today we have the sicknesses because of the sin of man. It wasn't God. Has been attacking our body. Praise God, but these are afflictions that we have to go through. Being a paramedic for over 20 years, praise God, siendo un paramédico por más de 20 años, yo he visto personas aflictas, hermanos, con su condición. I've seen people who have been afflicted by their condition. Praise God, hallelujah. The number one thing I think that has happened in the United States is diabetes. La cosa número uno que yo he visto hoy en los Estados Unidos es el diabetes. Ya casi todo el mundo tiene diabetes. You haven't noticed that? ¿Tú no has notado eso? Casi todo el mundo tiene diabetes. You haven't noticed that almost everybody has diabetes? Some form of another hypoglycemia, hyperglycemia. You know? But it's the highest thing that I've seen in the United States of America. And it all has to do with what? Food! With the diet that we've been taking in the United States of America, it's great! Because we love to eat. Nos encanta comer, hermanos. Alaba a Dios ahora, si puede. Nos encanta comer, hermanos. Praise God. Y por esa razón estamos enfermos. Y somos aflicciones de dónde? Del mundo. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Está preguntando, número uno, es porque no tenemos que tener confianza cuando nos están diciendo que vamos a tener aflicción. Y aunque usted está aflictado, hermanos, en su cuerpo, usted puede tener confianza que Dios ha vencido al mundo. Has victory over the world. Amen. Praise God. You know what? I've noticed one thing is that when you're sick and when you're afflicted in your sickness, that's an opportunity for God to do a miracle. Cuando estás enfermo, alguien está afligido con enfermedades, es una oportunidad para que Dios haga un milagro en tu vida. Porque si todos estuviéramos bien, sabiendo la naturaleza del hombre, jamás y nunca hubiéramos buscado a Dios. Knowing the way nature of man, if we wouldn't need something from God, we would never seek Him. Just by the nature of God. Yeah. Praise God, hallelujah. Some of us will work 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, just to make that money. Bendito sea el nombre nuestro Dios. Praise God, hallelujah. We would have to look at the chapter 15 of the book of John, and the chapter 16 of the book of John, to understand why Jesus was talking about this. Well, I'm just going to get a synopsis, praise God, of what 7, 15, and 16 is talking about. Hallelujah. Voy a dar un sinopsis del capítulo 15 y 16 de lo que está diciendo Cristo. Cristo le está introduciendo, se le había terminado su ministerio. Se le está terminando el ministerio de Cristo. Psalms chapter 23. How many people ever read the book of Psalms? Psalms 23. It's number one of the most famous Psalms, praise God, besides Psalm 91. Amen? If anybody has ever read Psalm 23, we're going to go through it real quick. It doesn't have many verses. But I want to, to me, it's important for me to speak about Psalm 23. Because it runs in the same condition. Let me tell you something, the situation David had. ¿Sabemos cuánto David tenía, la situación que David tenía? ¿Cuánto tenía, sabían? How many people know what David's situation was? He was trying to be killed by his own son to take his kingdom. But still in all, he wrote the Psalms. Praise God. I can imagine that King David, when he wrote the Psalm, he was remembering when he was a shepherd of sheep. Se estaba recordando cuando era pastor de ovejas. Y él escribió esto. Pero put it up there for me. Jehová es mi pastor. Nada me faltará.
I love you.
You know I love you. I ain't got to tell it to you. But women